Hello and welcome. Today is Sunday, the 12th day of October 2014. My name is Derek. Welcome to today's Silver Chart Analysis, looking at the daily and the weekly charts. But before we do, a little word puzzle on the screen. And this contains a phrase of 11 words in these 18 columns. Each column is sorted chronologically and needs to be adjusted accordingly. So the C is either the first, second, or third column. The K, first, second, and third is the T, and all 18 of them. Each of these letters in here, the C, K, and the T, must be the first letter of a word. And the last three, E, H, and L, must be the last three letters of a word. There's 18 words. Spaces are ignored. And I'll give you the answer to this puzzle at the end of the broadcast. Silver Daily Chart. On Thursday, I was mentioning this was a correctionary phase within what has been a large bear market. And a correctionary phase is like an indecision type of period. You can't tell from looking at this if there's going to be a significant up move into this area here or a significant down move. Pretty impossible to tell, but as action develops within the next few days, it should get a lot easier. Step number one for reversal of this trend is having this band go sideways. Of course, price action stand within the band, which is between 1715 and 58. Would have the band go flat. For this to change on a to turn from bearish to bullish, step number one is flattening out, so that is playing in that step there. Step number two is establishing resistance, and I got two key levels. One is a psychological 18 mark, and the second is 1840, significant Fibonacci. So you establish resistance as step number two. The normal step number three is to come back to the band, which should start or should be newly rising to find some key support and then lift off and breaking whatever established resistance happens to be. At that point, I'd be considering a trend reversal and a multi-day bull market to be coming into play. On the contrary, if you start to notice that you break down below this level, well, you've already had your correctionary phase and what's a bear market and a manipulated market. So don't be surprised if it starts to break below 17, that it would test new lows. The current low right now is 1667. And where it go below that of the next leg, if there was one, difficult to point out. You got psychological 16 all the way down to those 1415 range I've been talking about on the more longer term time frames. Examples of failed moves would be, let's just assume it establishes resistance around this 1818 mark. Again, the band starting to go higher and it comes within the band. If the band, say, supports it for a little bit and then breaks lower, you'd be expecting to make new lows. Or if you find support within the band, but it doesn't make a higher high, thus a lower high, say it goes like 1790 and then starts to break down again, you'd be looking at failed breakout, fast move downside. And of course, polar opposite moves are the same as well for upwards action. So that would be your daily chart. Let's take a look at this now on the weekly time frame. Again, this area here, roughly around the mid 18 to low 19 area, which has been support on several occasions, would now be an area I'd be looking for resistance. The band, of course, is declining. Step number one is to get up to it to flatten out, but it's still got a decent a ways to get to that point. And when you get to the area, if on a rally up towards in here, then you get to this and now what situation for if it doesn't find much resistance, it continues to go higher, the possibility of a failed breakdown is in play. If you find resistance with a higher low and a move back up to the established area, then you'd be looking again for moving into step two, which would be breaking above the band. Thus, a move like this would be what they'd call a cup and handle, but that's a long ways away. Different things, of course, to be looking for. And normally, when you have a market where the target price is capitulating going down really badly in a free market, what that would mean is the holders of such, and in this case silver, are wanting to get out of the market, wanting to sell what they have, but are reluctantly finding a lack of buyers or people that might buy, but only if it's extremely cheap, thus lower bids. That would be normal, but that's not the case. Because interestingly enough, this last week, I get an email from a bullion dealer, Silver Gold Bull, stating a flash sale, which means 7,000 Sunshine Mint rounds were being sold that day. First 7,000 gets the discount of up to 50 cents additionally from their target price of what was already suppressed prices. So I happened to take a look. I was possibly considering getting in on the deal, but 40 minutes after the email, they're already sold all 7,000, which means a lot of people came in and bought and or a massive purchase. Purchasing 7,000 rounds is a six-figure cost right now. So that doesn't tell me that the demand is really low. It tells me the demand is actually decent. And of course, that doesn't make sense for the manipulated lower prices, but of course, you know how the market makers work. You can't be too surprised about that either. So again, I find that fairly interesting to say the least. So that'll be it for the analysis. Now let's go to the answer to this. What would this be? Well, it would be central bankers have killed our money with this debt-based model. Thank you for tuning in, and have yourself a magnificent week. Bye-bye.